Aging is a fundamental process that happens to all living creatures. It's really a very basic question. What is the nature of biological time? And at the personal level, every one of us experiences aging, and it affects our family, it affects society. And so we hope that by studying simple animal models, we can gain insight into the aging process and promote health into old age. One of the remarkable findings over the last several decades from the biology of aging field is that animal longevity is malleable and regulated by genes and environment. And in particular, there are evolutionarily conserved metabolic signaling pathways that can extend the lifespan across taxa. We use the model organism of C. elegans and the killifish Notobranchius fritzieri to actually study how genes and environment impact the lifespan of these animals in real time. And the question arises, how do these various pathways promote longevity? What are the mechanisms? We also wonder, are there common convergent mechanisms that all these pathways impinge upon? And we think this is an important question because it gets at the heart of longevity.
I'm trying to figure out ways that an organism can recover, repair, and potentially rejuvenate. And these things might be happening in this small worm called C. elegans after it refeeds from a prolonged fast. So during this refeeding process, there's a regrowth and repair of the neuromuscular system. There's a reversal of some of the accumulated damages that have occurred, and also it regains its reproductive ability. So by learning the cellular and molecular strategies that the worm uses for recovery and repair, maybe we can leverage some of that to recover lost aspects of health during human aging.
I'm following up what we discovered previously in the lab, that was that there is a negative correlation between lifespan and the nucleolar size. So the bigger the nucleolus, the shorter the animals live. And I'm trying to find what the proteins that are involved in these nucleolar size changes do also to lifespan. And for this, I'm working with C. elegans.
DNA and RNA can sometimes be misplaced in the compartments of the cell. And my main project here in Adam's lab focuses on understanding whether this process has an impact on inflammaging, which is the inflammation that its levels elevate during aging. When I first joined the department, what really fascinated me was how warm people were at introducing me into their groups and how easy it was to integrate both scientifically and as a friend among the people of my lab.
I'm exploring how aging impacts energy homeostasis using killifish as a model system. Energy homeostasis is a biological process that coordinates food intake and energy production. And we know with aging, the energy homeostasis becomes dysfunctional and associated with the onset of these different metabolic disorders, like type 2 diabetes, for example. And understanding better how aging affects energy homeostasis, we can prevent all in once all these metabolic disorders. In the Adams Lab, we have all the freedoms to define our research project based on our interest. And I think this is the most exciting thing of doing science here.
So when I decided to do my postdoc here, I did it because I really like the institute. I think the facilities are amazing. And I thought that there was a very friendly environment within the lab. And I think that after 2 years, this holds true and that we all are friends and we help each other. So yeah, that's why I really like working in the Antebi lab.
Here, there are so many departments, different people who have completely different ideas about aging. And it's really exciting for me to try and understand aging from different angles, different perspectives. So there's no place I'd rather be to study aging than here.
Well, science is a social enterprise, and it really relies on people interacting well with one another. I just have really fantastic, fun, collaborative people, and that makes science really exciting. So come join us.